The Air and Space Forces Association's annual Air, Space, and Cyber Conference returned to National Harbor, Maryland this week. The conference was buzzing with big topics including aerial refueling tankers, drone wingmen for fighter jets, the planned rollout of the next stealth bomber, and the future of the F-35 fighter's engine. Air Mobility Command announced the KC-46 Pegasus, its latest tanker, had been cleared to carry out all refueling missions around the world, such as combat missions, and could refuel all planes. But there's still one exception. The A-10 Warthog, due to a problem with the stiffness of the KC-46's boom, that is now being redesigned. L3 Harris and Brazilian aerospace firm Embraer also made a play for the U.S. tanker market, announcing plans to modify Embraer's KC-390 to sell it to the Air Force. L3 and Embraer plan to add boom refueling capabilities to the KC-390, which now uses a hose and drogue system, as well as modernized communications equipment that can meet the U.S.'s latest command and control standards. And they tout the so-called agile tanker's ability to take off and land from short and rough runways, which they say could come in handy if the Air Force had to set up an improvised base in the field during a future war. The Air Force is also all in on the concept of having autonomous drone wingmen flying alongside fighter jets. Secretary Frank Kendall has made these collaborative combat aircraft one of his top priorities. He envisions about 5 drones using artificial intelligence flying into battle alongside fighters such as the F-35 or the futuristic next-generation air dominance platform. The concept is similar to the Royal Australian Air Force's Loyal Wingman program, which uses Boeing's MQ-28 Ghostbat drone. Companies such as Kratos, General Atomics, and Lockheed Martin are just a few of the other defense firms that have been working on similar programs. The Air Force is looking to have a competition for this program in 2024. The B-21 Raider will have its public debut the first week of December, Air Force Acquisition Chief Andrew Hunter announced. The Air Force's next stealth bomber will have its official rollout at Northrop Grumman's facility in Palmdale, California. Its first flight is planned to follow a few months later in 2023, when it flies from Palmdale to Edwards Air Force Base, where its formal flight tests will take place. And will the F-35 get a new advanced adaptive engine? Pratt & Whitney and General Electric Aviation also made their pitches for the future of the F-35's propulsion system. GE is arguing their next generation XA-100 engine, part of the Adaptive Engine Transition Program, will provide the thrust, speed, fuel efficiency, and cooling ability the F-35 will need for its latest Block 4 upgrades. Pratt & Whitney is touting the benefits and cost savings of upgrading their F-135 engine, which is currently in the F-35, under their enhanced engine package. Pratt is also working on its own adaptive engine, but says that's a better fit for the Air Force's future NGAD program. Air Force Chief of Staff General C.Q. Brown had a roundtable here. Here's what he had to say about the future of the F-35's propulsion system.
We need to look at whatever the follow-on advanced propulsion is going to be for the F-35, whether it's AETP or EEP. The other piece of this is actually, as they're doing the business case analysis, what's in the OSD is we'd like to get to a decision this year, to get to a point to be able to, you know, which way we're going to go, and then that way we can better invest, to ensure we're going to provide opportunities here in the future.
Those are just a few of the many things that were discussed at AFA's Airspace Cyber Conference. For more coverage on that and other issues, head to defensenews.com. For Defense News, I'm Stephen Losey.